Morning, Dixie Heights. Today is December 12th, 2023. I'm Malcolm.
I'm Kennedy.
And I'm Zebriah, and this is the Dixie Heights News.
There are two celebratory Christmas parties happening after school today. The annual Buddy Club Christmas celebration will be today, Tuesday, December 12th in the cafeteria. Come for good stories, the smiles, the Christmas punch, Christmas carols, and all-around Christmas merriment. Any questions, please see Ms. Brockman in room 205.
And the Dixie Heights FFA holiday party will be today after school until 4. Be prepared to decorate some cookies for our upcoming bake sale and play a few reindeer games. Bring the drink with you.
And after the party, feel free to stay on campus and check out the winter band concert in the auditorium with the first song at 7.
Not to be outdone, the Dixie Heights Winter Choir Concert is Thursday in the auditorium with the first song at 7.
The Dixie Heights esports team will be kicking off the season in February, compete against other schools in Rocket League, Madden, NBA 2K, and a variety of other games. Please use the sign-up sheets posted near the cafeteria or email Mr. Hagedorn if you are interested.
What's that sound? Is it an elf or an orc? Come join the D&D Club on an adventure. There will be two meetings this week. The first is Wednesday from 2:40 to 4 in Miss Hume's room, 1306. And we will have a second meeting during Pride on Friday for those that find it difficult to meet after school in Mr. Beer's room, 0304. If you need a little magic or want to practice your rogue-like tendencies, come and join the adventure.
And now to Ava and Hank the Tank for sports.
Good morning, it's Hank the Tank.
And Ava, it's a great day at Dixie.
The girls' basketball team plays tonight against Simon Kenton. The games are here at home, and we would love to see you there. Good luck, ladies.
Boys' basketball continues their season tonight at Holmes High School. Varsity tip-off is at 7:30, JV is at 6, themed Christmas.
Wrestling has a tri-match at Dixie tomorrow, starting at 5:30. Colonel Pride, and now back to Dixie.
Saga will meet twice this week. The first time is after school on Tuesday.
Today.
From 2:40 to 3:45 to celebrate the holidays, and we will have a second meeting during Pride on Friday for those that find it difficult to meet after school. Both meetings will be in Ms. Hume's room, 1306. Sometimes during the holidays, it is hard to remember how fabulous you are, so you are welcome to our meetings if you are in need of a little bit of a boost or if you have a sparkle to share. Hope to see you there. If you have any queries, contact Ms. Hume.
Are you interested in joining the Science Club for quick recall and Olympic level practice in biology, chemistry, physics, math, and more? Our next meeting will be after school in the Mr. Beer's room on Wednesday, January 10th. Students of all grades are welcome. See the Mr. Beard for more information.
It's the time of year again. As such, we want to extend a helping hand to those in need this holiday season through the Toys for Tots program. This program reaches out to local hospitals helping youth currently in the hospital and also the siblings of those hospitalized. It helps inspire hope and joy during the holidays, especially when going through their own struggles. Ms. Poston is asking for your help in donating toys for our Dixie FFA Community Pride Project with our partners over at B105 Radio. Jenna Edwards is our FFA chairperson spearheading this charitable community effort.
So please help us help others by bringing in any toys and drop them off at our collection boxes located in the commons area at the front of the school, in the gym common area, and as always in Ms. Poston's room 308. FFA thanks you in advance for your help.
And now for the lunch menu with David and Alan.
Hello y'all, this is David and this is Alan with the lunch menu. Today's lunch is breakfast for lunch, which means
pancakes, French toast, sausage, chocolate milk.
Oh, forgot the eggs, buddy.
Eggs.
There we go.
Pancakes, French toast, sausage, chocolate milk, eggs.
Alright. Hash browns, strawberry banana applesauce cup, hamburger and cheeseburger, mega pizza box, and entree salad. Alright. Tomorrow's breakfast. Alright. Tomorrow's breakfast is
yogurt, chocolate milk. Yogurt, chocolate milk.
Okay. Cake donut, blueberries, and 1% low fat milk. And now back to the fantastic mainstream news.
The Nicole Tucker Swim and Dive Meet will be held on December 16th at Scott High School. The meet will begin at 9 a.m. and all proceeds will go to the Nicole Tucker Foundation. Also, we will be accepting donations in the form of silent auction items or monetary donations through December 11th. Anyone with questions or donation items can contact Ms. Johnson directly.
Ms. Bevins is inviting everyone to come check out the art gallery. Art 1 and Art 2 classes have been working hard on realism, watercolor, and ASL hands. Doors are open all day and the artwork will be displayed until next Friday, December 15th.
12 Days of Christmas continues Wednesday as Dressed Like a Christmas Tree.
And here is today's Christmas clue for Colonel.
Yesterday's clue of the day was Santa's Tummy by Ariana Grande, and today's clue is, when accidentally transported to the North Pole as a baby and raised by elves, he can't shake the feeling of not belonging and goes on a crazy adventure to find his father. Make sure to DM us on DHHS_news to get your prize.
And remember, Dixie, make today better than yesterday.
And here is your thought of the day.
There is probably a student in your classroom right now who feels terribly and horribly alone. They might act like they have it all together, and to the students around them, it might seem that way, putting on a smile, getting some work done, going through the motions. But as a teacher, you hear parts of their story that other students don't hear. You know that some of your kids only get food when they come to school, and on nights and weekends, they go hungry. You've driven by those students' houses that don't have heat or windows or floors. You were told by the school social worker which of your students are in foster care. You've had parents call you and tell you what's going on at home and how they're struggling to keep it all together. And you, a math teacher, or science, or history, or English, or Spanish, or whatever teacher, are sometimes also just a listening board for these parents. You've got kids who are acting crazy right now because they're not looking forward to the Christmas break coming up, not looking forward to a couple weeks away from regular food and heat and structure and you. You've got kids in your class who are feeling very alone right now. So let me say this. Thank you for being in those students' lives. Thanks for not just teaching the subject matter, even though that's usually all you get evaluated for. Thanks for keeping granola bars in your desk. Thanks for listening to those parents during your planning time, even though you have papers to grade. Thanks for stopping in the hallway so a kid can pour their heart out to you, or just for giving them high fives. Thanks for being intentional about creating an atmosphere in your classroom that students do feel cared for and safe in. I mean, this wasn't in the job description. Building a community, leading a community. They didn't teach you how to deal with this stuff in teacher college. This isn't what's assessed on the Common Core. It's not on the SAT. And yet, it is a part of your job and one of the most difficult aspects of it. But it's also one of the most important.
Awesome.